if you can give me some emotion, that'd be great.
All right.
So tell me your full name, name of your business, where you're from, and how you started. If you could speak just a little bit louder, it would help a lot. And just tell me, like, how did you get started with this work?
Well, I've been doing it for a while. I started since 1989. I've been giving resource person for a number of organizations, working through the Caribbean Development Bank, and doing different projects throughout the Caribbean and in Guyana itself. I later on came to the United States and responsible for the Carter Hall Foundation for International Education in New York, where I had an opportunity to teach at a school, high school here, and middle school. And after that, I was a visiting artist at the St. John's University in Philadelphia. So I had quite an extensive opportunities to, you know, show my craft and practice my craft and stuff like that.
All right. So as you went through your years since you've been here, from a child where you were practicing art and getting involved in stuff like that, and now actually taking it into a business, how did you get involved as a business person in art in DC?
Well, I was in business before I got here. I had my own studio in Guyana, and we used to sell a lot of our products to the Caribbean, for the Caribbean tourist market, and to the hospitality services like the hotels and restaurants and so on. So doing business was a part of, you know, my background. I grew up in a family that did business for a number of years. We run a whole pharmacy. I had my own, a number of other businesses that we did. I started about maybe four different businesses in Ghana before I came to the United States. So I came with a wealth of experience and understand them. So I just take it to a different level, because we cater for the tourist market in the Caribbean and elsewhere. So when I came here, after a time I just decided that I'm going to do it in a more personalized way, where I just do sculpture. And I felt that that was the way to go, because I was very talented, but I never had an opportunity to do sculpture. But now I have the opportunity to do so. So it was just the next step. It's just the next step. But business is always a part of my
So you had extensive business background before you came here. So, yeah, you was. Would you consider yourself to be a small business?
Yes, I am.
Okay. All right.
And I think that small business has its place. We employed, even here when we were doing business, we had, you know, great employment for a few young people. And as we grow, we probably will be able to create employment for some other people.
So you're going good so far. Just keep it in like small bites, so it'll be easier for us to edit and make the story together, right? But I like everything that you said. So you have extensive business, your small business, you've already incubated your business, right? How do you see yourself, or how do you see other small businesses getting to the point where you are? For example, like somebody's in the local community, they're an artist, they have talent, but they don't have the expertise to take it from a concept in their head to actually tangible products. How do you see people can get to that point?
Well, I think that it's all trial and error. You have to have to be brave enough to go out there and try new things, especially in marketing. I think a lot of young people are, people produce a lot of good products. The problem is that in America, it's very competitive, and you kind of get lost in the, in the swamp, so to speak. So you have to try new things. And now with technology that is introduced, you can probably use the different platforms that you can use, like maybe Facebook, Instagram, and all the other different platforms, and try to see if you can create a niche for yourself by putting your products out there and having people get accustomed to you, get acquainted with your work. And I think that will work. That's one of the things that they can work, you know. So you can create your own audience, people who like your work, and you just decide to go out there, and you know, you never know what will happen. But you have to get out there, put your work out.
So speaking about audience, here is an audience for you. How do you see the Busy Bee, you know, Juanita's business is Busy Bee International. How do you see Busy Bee International being a platform to get an audience for small businesses? What do you see?
Well, I think it's a very good opportunity that Juanita has provided for young small businesses, because it's an opportunity where they can come out and test the products, test the water, so to speak, to see how people respond to your work. She have a very loyal customers who come every year, and they're looking for products, they repeat. They come here every time we have a show, and they will support the artists here. So I think this is a very good opportunity that Juanita has provided for local artists in the area. And I think this is a good way of starting out with little shows like this. And then, you know, as you find your audience, you can develop and get bigger. But I think this is a very good opportunity. At least I commend her a lot, providing the space that young artists can come out and do. I think she's doing an excellent job.
All right, great. And finally, let's say, for example, she receives an award a couple of years down the road, right? Would you, what tribute would you pay to her?
Busy Bee to me is a very special person, as I said before. And I think she deserves any award that comes to her, any, recognition that comes to her. I think she deserves it, because as a woman, not just as a woman, but as a person, she thinks about everyone. I mean, she gives people an opportunity to come out here. And when I didn't have a space or a place, I was able to talk with her, and she was more than willing to, you know, have me come in and be a part of the show. And this is our fourth year here. And this is the place that I sold my first piece. When I started doing sculpture, I've been doing pottery before, like top pottery, but you know, so we changed the game right here at Busy Bee. So I think that Busy deserves all the recognition that she will get. And I would be one in support, making sure that she gets that kind of recognition that she so rightfully deserves.
As soon as he's finished knocking, if I could have you say that piece one more time. No, it's fine. Don't want to interrupt that too much. Alright, if you could say that last piece.
I'm saying that to me, BZ is a special person. And there's not too many people like her who is willing to organize a space that artists can come and really work and have an opportunity to show their work. And so I will commend her highly for something like this, because she's been doing this for, this is our 120 something shows, and it's I can't remember how many years, but she's been here for quite some time. And it's a huge undertaking, and she has handled it. She's handled it very well, and I would encourage her to continue. I am great support for
Yeah, I don't want to, you know.